Very good afternoon to one and all present here. Myself, Dr. Divya, postgraduate student in the Department of Physiology, Lady Cowden Medical College. I extend a hearty welcome to all for the All India Online Physiology Festival 2020. I would like to thank all the faculty members, audience, and participants for taking part in this 4 days festival. I hope you all have enjoyed the past 3 days event, and I'm sure that you all are looking forward to know the winners who would add feathers to their caps today. So let's not waste time anymore. To start today's celebration, I request Dr. Sunita Mundal ma'am, Head of Physiology Department in Lady Cowden Medical College and also the organizing chairperson of this festival to say a few words. Ma'am, please.
So, thank you, Dr. Divya. A very good afternoon to all present today on this festival, All India Online Festival, Physiology Festival 2020. And on behalf of the whole team of Department of Physiology, Lady Harding Medical College, I, Dr. Sunita Mundal, Director, Professor and Head of Physiology, welcome all the students and faculties of various medical colleges from all over India. Today is the fourth and the last day of our journey of Physiology Festival. I must say, what a fascinating journey we have had over the last 3 days. It was an exhilarating experience watching our young students coming up with skits, poetry, and animation. I'm really happy to welcome our distinguished guests who have joined us, taking out their valuable time from their busy schedule to judge our function. We have Dr. K.K. Deepak, Head of Department of Physiology at All India Institute of Medical Sciences, New Delhi. And Dr. Deepak is a stalwart from the field of physiology. I welcome you, sir. I welcome Dr. Anil Gurtu, our Vice Principal, Head of Medicine, and clinician par excellence, a medical educationist, an ardent mountaineer, a poet, and a painter, who shall be joining us from Lady Harding. I welcome you, sir. Now, I hand over the platform to Dr. Anita and Dr. Madhulika to carry on with today's session. Thank you. Over to you, Dr. Anita.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Good afternoon, all. I welcome you all to the fourth and final day of our festival. We are truly grateful for the love and acceptance that has been showered, which is evident by the enthusiastic viewership of our live streams and also the huge number of votes we have received daily over the last 3 days. Though excited about today's category competition, we are also saddened by the thought that today would be the last day for us to be with the faculty and students from across India. But rather than having such melancholy thoughts, let us try to create beautiful memories for everyone till we meet again in our next festival. The famous Ukrainian businessman and philanthropist Viktor Pinchuk says, "Art, freedom, and creativity will change society faster than politics." I believe that the current time happens to be one of the most dynamic times of all. And it is time now for all of us to move forward, find new ways of doing things, create new unified academic atmosphere with a focus on learning, creating, and bringing vibrant progressive changes in the society. This festival is a small attempt towards this change, and we thank everyone, faculty and students alike, for being a part of this endeavor. Without your support, we wouldn't have been able to build this united family of students and physiologists across India. Moving ahead with today's competition, as was in previous 3 days, the participants have already submitted their respective entries in the form of a video, which would be played one after other. The time limit for each video is 5 minutes. We have 3 prizes for the category, first, second, and third, to be decided by our judges for the day. We also have an audience choice award, and the link of the same has been activated and is shared in the description box. The voting would start the voting would be stopped within 30 minutes of the end of the screening of the last entry. And the announcement of the prizes would be done immediately after 30 minutes of the end of the screening of the last entry. Now, it gives me immense pleasure to introduce to you all our esteemed judges of the day. It is our privilege to have with us
Madhulika, sorry, could you please move your screen? You are not coming on the screen at all.
Something gone wrong with my camera?
She's coming on the... Thoda sa you appearing on the side. If you can just come bit on the... Move your camera so that you come bit on the center.
Okay, let me try it.
Yeah, absolutely right. Absolutely right. Thank you.
Okay. Just one sec, please give me a minute. I can't see Dr. Deepak. Is Dr. Deepak here? Dr. Deepak? I guess sir is muted or sir's camera is not working.
Sir has left the meeting, or maybe he got disconnected.
Dr. Deepak seems to be there. Doesn't seem to be here. I think some network issue. So I guess. So do we continue or should we wait for sir to join? Can you hear me, Anita?
Yes, I can. Should I call him?
Okay, so Dr. Anita, can I request you to introduce Dr. Gurtu in the meantime?
Sure.
And I will, okay,
sir,
Dr. Okay. Deepak has joined back.
Yes, he has.
Sir, could you please switch on your camera?
Go ahead, please go ahead.
Dr. Deepak, please.
Yeah, Dr. Madhulika, I think cameras are not working on your this thing. Even mine is on, but it's not showing anything. And even Dr. Anita Power's one device is not showing her.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Sir, I'm using another account for speaking. Okay. I'm not using my own account.
Please go ahead.
Okay, fine. Thank you, sir. We were waiting for you to join back, sir.
Yeah.
So, as I said, I was introducing Dr. Deepak. So it is a privilege to have you with us, sir. Dr. Deepak is professor and head Department of Physiology at All India Institute of Medical Sciences, Delhi. He obtained his MBBS degree from GMC Bhopal in 1981 and postgraduate degree in 1984 and PhD degree in physiology in 1990 from AIIMS. He has been serving as faculty in the Department of Physiology since 1987. Recently, he has been awarded DSc degree from Swayasa University from Bangalore. All physiologists recognize Sir's contribution in not only setting up the Autonomic Function Lab, the first lab of its kind in the country way back in 1986, but also constantly incorporating and developing newer technologies in the field of autonomic function, testing like indigenous software for quantification of autonomic tone by HRV and vascular tone by blood pressure variability, devising blood pressure simulation model techniques and devising techniques of EMG biofeedback, to list a few of the innovations that he has incorporated. He also continues to work in basic research in the field of yoga and meditation. He is currently also exploring its applications during space and gravitational exposures. He has significantly contributed in the field of medical education and published several studies. He delivered several invited talks in various countries and has been instrumental in bringing the Memorandum of Understanding between AIIMS New Delhi and UCSD San Diego, USA. for pursuing space physiology research at Ames. His group presently is pursuing research in the field of space physiology involving lower body negative pressure as well as lower body positive pressure. He has filed a patent for pro-gravity body gear to create gravity during microgravity exposure in 2016, and the same has been published in 2018. He has published 136 full-length index research papers, which have more than 2,200 citations with H index of 24 in Google Scholar. I could go on and on, but I think I have time. Try to sum up Sir's huge personality in mere few words. Thank you so much for joining us today, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Madhulika. Now, I, Dr. Anita Pawar, Professor, Department of Physiology. It gives me an immense pleasure to welcome Dr. Anil Gurtu, Vice Principal and Head of the Department of Medicine of our Institute, Lady Harding Medical College. Dr. Anil Gurtu is a renowned, respected academician and clinician. He has published many papers in national and international journals, not just in the field of medicine, but also in our medical humanities. He has worked tirelessly to improve the healthcare delivery in our institute, and his most recent accomplishment is to have established the first thalassemia transition care clinic in the country in the medicine department of our institute with interdepartmental collaboration. While medicine forms the directive purpose of his life, a commingling of four passions gives meaning to his life: mountaineering, poetry, painting, and photography. His artwork has also been exhibited in well-known art centers of Delhi. A truly multifaceted personality, other interests that animate his lifespan are the spectrum from ethics and law, medical education and communication, creative writing, astrophysics and cosmology, nature and wildlife. He's the chairman of the medical education unit of our institute, and under his stewardship, the medical education unit of our institute started programs for the welfare and development of our undergraduate students, like the mentorship program and the student leadership mission. He's an active mountaineer with interest in high altitude medicine and physiology. And he has done over 21 climbs in Himalayas, including Mount Everest via North Ridge, via the Tibetan route, where he ran a month-long medical station at ABC and the North Pole, which is above 21,000 feet, and Mount Kanchenjunga too. And just not the one, just hold your breath, because he's also an avalanche survivor from a climb he did in Siachen Glacier. Thank you so much for joining us today, sir. I welcome all of you once more, and without any further delay, I request Dr. Sonu, our senior resident and coordinator for the miscellaneous category, to start with the competition.
A very good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining an All India Online Physiology Festival 2020. I would like to thank our respected director, Professor N.N. Mathur, head of the department, Professor Sunita Mandal, Professor Madhulika Monga, and Professor Anita Pawar, for giving me an opportunity to act as coordinator for miscellaneous category. We got total 14 entries, and we are delighted having active participation of UG students from PAN India. I would like to remind the audience that voting links are given in the description box, which will not active, and it will be active once live streaming is started, and it will close half an hour after stopped. Kindly do vote and support your favorite team without wasting your time. I would like to start live streaming our first team, Bernard Ellis, on the topic hemorrhagic shock.
Monday morning, a busy traffic road.
His way to meet his love, Raj goes flapping like a baby dove.
Oh, a message from my dearest Simran.
The message sounded urgent. Catecholamines increase his pace.
He must run to greet Simran with grace.
He looked down at the screen. A horn suddenly intervened.
Oh dear Lord, brought a poor fate. Our Raj is injured and the scene is pictured.
Help was rushed and the crowd was shushed.
On the way to hospital, the condition felt feeble.
The case was very serious. Not a second could be wasted.
He was taken to OT and the operation was hasted.
Dr. Jhatka and his team of surgeons were handed the case. It was all a matter of pace.
It is a case of hemorrhagic shock. We have to hurry. 40% of total blood volume is already lost.
While the surgeons are busy with their work, let's dive into the physiology world.
Hypovolemic shock occurs when the amount of fluid is inadequate, resulting in decreased circulating blood volume. Hemorrhagic shock is the most major form of hypovolemic shock.
Let's discuss the mechanism. Due to decreased blood flow, the tissue perfusion is decreased and increased anaerobic conditions causes lactic acidosis.
The sequence of events is divided into rapid compensatory reaction and long-term compensatory reaction.
Rapid compensatory reactions start within minutes of shock condition. The hemorrhage results in decreased venous return, which in turn causes decreased baroreceptor activity and increased chemoreceptor activity. The combined effect is increased sympathetic discharge.
Increased sympathetic discharge has a wide range of effects like tachycardia, thready pulse, generalized vasoconstriction and venoconstriction. It also stimulates radicular activating system to produce irritability and adrenal medulla to increase catecholamines release. The major result is increased cardiac output.
Now we shall discuss the elaborated effects of renal vasoconstriction. Renal ischemia due to hemorrhage stimulates the release of angiotensin II, which then causes intense thirst. The constriction of afferent and efferent arterioles will ultimately increase the filtration fraction.
The increased filtration fraction will produce oligouria, increased sodium retention, retention of nitrogenous waste, and later on could result in acute renal failure.
The long-term compensatory reactions mainly focus on restoration of plasma volume within 12 to 72 hours. This begins with mobilization of tissue fluid by arteriolar constriction due to increased sympathetic discharge. The overall effect is decreased capillary pressure, which causes an increase in the uptake of tissue fluid due to pressure gradient.
Hemorrhage results in four conditions which trigger various pathways in kidney that ultimately result in retention of water and electrolytes, hence aiding the restoration of plasma volume. These conditions are as
decreased volume causes decreased venous return and hence signaling the atriocaval baroreceptors to stimulate antidiuretic hormone secretion.
Renal ischemia decreases glomerular filtration rate, which trigger angiotensin II secretion via renin-angiotensin-aldosterone pathway.
Decreased tissue perfusion signals aldosterone secretion via adrenals, which result in increased sodium reabsorption.
Increased stress to body stimulates feedback pathway that ultimately cause increased glucocorticoid secretion.
Long-term compensatory reactions also includes restoration of plasma protein and red blood cells. This restoration takes about 4 to 8 weeks.
Oh God, we almost forgot about our dear Raj.
Now that we have covered the underlying physiology, let's hear about the treatment from Dr. Jhatka himself.
Here, the best possible therapy is transfusion of whole blood. When unavailable, then plasma alone can be used. Artificial substitutes of plasma, such as dextran solution, are also used.
Don't worry, Simran. If it's not happy, it's not an end.
It was a nice performance by Bernard Elias, and now I am going to stream the team session on the topic sympathetic response.
Greetings to all. Our team Frisson presents a short video on sympathetic response. So here we go.
So props are about to come. They are on our head, and here comes the emergency situation. So our body came up with the flight or fight response. So our hypothalamus gets heated up, the temperature increases, and from here comes two systems at operation and together. First is sympathetic adrenal medullary system, and second hypothalamo-pituitary-adrenal-cortex system. Both are coordinating to work back with the stress. So what are its reactions on different organs? As we see for the heart rate increase, force of contraction increase, cardiac output increases, lungs, bronchus dilates and aortic exhales out, pupil dilates. Lipid metabolism is altered. It is shifted towards lipolysis, glycogenolysis and ketogenesis, all bubble out throughout the liver into the blood. The penis ejaculates and GIT has got tired, so motility is decreased and it's no more ready to take food. So the gates are closed and hence sphincters remain contracted. Have you also experienced something when you are anxious or in fear? Do you think that you'll wet your clothes with your creepy bladder? Oh, your guess is wrong. Here we see this GIF. When sympathetic system is activated, as in the case of stress, norepinephrine acts via alpha and beta receptors and this leads to contraction of your internal and external sphincter. This causes retention of urine. So nothing to worry about, guys. So after having fun with our observation, let's have a look who is the culprit behind all this. So when sympathetic system is activated, the prefrontal neurons sympathetic system at the same time. When the synapse with chromaffin cells, they release epinephrine and norepinephrine both directly into circulation. And when they synapse with postganglionic neurons, they release only norepinephrine at axon terminals. Now, this epinephrine and norepinephrine released will have differential action on different organs. And that is possible because of the presence of four different receptors, that is alpha 1, alpha 2, beta 1 and beta 2 receptors. Let's see them one by one. As we can see, the alpha 2 receptors, they are causing the decrease in cyclic AMP levels and hence are inhibitory in nature. They are present on sympathetic postganglionic nerve terminal. What is their action there? Why they want the inhibition? So basically, the activation of alpha 2 receptors by norepinephrine released from the same terminals inhibits further release of norepinephrine from these terminals. But oops, what we are seeing here? The adrenal glands are crying, they are a little upset and exhausted. What has happened to them? Yeah, we have got it right. They are depleted of their catecholamine sources because of the prolonged stage of stress. Why is it so? The reason is, we have a point here that they are devoid of alpha 2 receptors. Now, are we able to see some other observations? Like the peripheral vessel being constricted and crying out of it? Or the heart working strenuously, or the vasodilation of the vessels in the muscles. So why it's all happening? Now we have norepinephrine and epinephrine acting on these receptors. Norepinephrine, when it acts with alpha 1 receptor and beta 1 receptors, it increases the force of contraction. The beta 1 receptors are present on SA node, AV node and the muscles of atria and ventricles also. So it also increases heart rate and conduction velocity. So all of this increases the systolic and diastolic BP. But with the action of epinephrine on beta 2 receptors, it causes vasodilation and hence it provides the extra nutrient that are being required by the skeletal muscle during heavy workout. So after looking at so many functions of nervous system, let's see what if someone lost it. So here we see a man who once got hit by a cow horn and got Horner syndrome, huh? And his right side of the sympathetic trunk of the neck has damaged. So kind of his sympathetic system is lost. How he came to know about this? He get poured all over by the cocaine. On the affected side, the cocaine has blocked reuptake of norepinephrine innervating pupillary dilator muscle, so cause prolonged pupillary dilation. And on the affected side, there is not enough norepinephrine, so pupillary dilation doesn't occur. So how he presents with the symptoms? He shows ptosis, that is drooping of eyelid because of non-contraction of the eyelid muscles. Meiosis, that is the constriction of the pupil because of non-dilation of the pupil. And anhidrosis, that is decreased sweating in the affected side.
Excellent performance by Team Physiology. Now I am going to live stream Team Hive Minds on the topic health syndrome.
Here, we have a case where a 28-year-old pregnant lady comes to get a routine checkup done in her first trimester. Upon conducting the necessary examinations, the doctor concludes no abnormalities. However, patient history shows that this is her second pregnancy and she has a history of preeclampsia. The patient arrives at the hospital prior to a scheduled ultrasound at the beginning of the 31st week of pregnancy. The doctor observes generalized edema and moderate obesity. She starts antihypertensive medication and asks her to regularly monitor her blood pressure and blood glucose. The patient comes back later for her scheduled third ultrasound, but this time she presents with a few complaints.
Hello doctor, I'm experiencing frequent headaches. I also feel more tired and feverish, especially at night. I feel dizzy and my vision blurs when I stand suddenly. My pregnancy has been so smooth so far. This is the first time I'm facing such problems.
It hurts here.
The doctor advises certain laboratory tests to be done. The results are as follows. The doctor gets the lab reports and thinks about the possible diagnosis. He consults with the pathologist and thinks that the elevated liver enzymes, low platelets, increased bilirubin level, decreased RBC, and other abnormalities can be indicative of a rare condition called HELLP syndrome. To be sure, he takes the opinion of a fellow consultant. Before we see their conversation, let us have an overview of HELLP syndrome. It is a group of symptoms which develop usually before the 37th week of pregnancy or within 48 hours of delivery. This rare and idiopathic condition affects less than 1% of pregnant women. This number may seem insignificant, however, owing to its high mortality rate, this condition should not be overlooked.
My patient is presenting the following symptoms: acute pain in right hypochondrium and epigastrium, malaise, nausea, vomiting, headache, blurring of vision, slurring of speech, exacerbation of the symptoms during the night. So in my opinion, this presentation satisfies the triad of HELLP syndrome, that is, hemolysis, elevated liver enzyme and low platelets. Before starting treatment, considering this as a definitive diagnosis, do you agree with my clinical interpretation?
Have you ruled all the differentials?
Yes, idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura, systemic lupus erythematosus and hemolytic uremic syndrome were considered by me. But all the diagnostic parameters indicate total HELLP syndrome.
I concur with your diagnosis. Let's go ahead with the treatment protocol for HELLP syndrome and preeclampsia.
The patient has recovered successfully after treatment. The doctor and patient have a conversation about possible post-treatment complications.
You are very lucky to have survived. This syndrome can be fatal if not diagnosed on time. Up to 25% women do not survive this. Unexpected rapid deaths because of HELLP syndrome require forensic testing. It is great that you did not suffer from a hepatic rupture. It usually results in death. Hemorrhage and stroke may also occur.
You detected it early, so you saved my life. Thank you so much.
Corticosteroid treatment worked wonders for you and your baby. It promoted lung maturity and for you, your edema diminished, thrombocytic microangiopathic anemia was prevented, which means that your blood vessels don't get blocked. Your platelet count has also improved significantly.
Greeting.
Excellent.
Here we have a case where a 28-year-old pregnant lady comes to get a routine checkup done in her first trimester. Upon conducting the necessary examinations, the doctor concludes no abnormalities. However, patient history shows that this is her second pregnancy and she has a history of preeclampsia. The patient arrives at the hospital prior to a scheduled ultrasound at the beginning of the 31st week of pregnancy. The doctor observes generalized edema and moderate obesity. She starts antihypertensive medication and asks her to regularly monitor her blood pressure and blood glucose. The patient comes back later for her scheduled third ultrasound, but this time she presents with a few complaints.
Hello doctor, I'm experiencing frequent headaches. I also feel more tired and feverish, especially at night. I feel dizzy and my vision blurs when I stand suddenly. My pregnancy has been so smooth so far. This is the first time I'm facing such problems.
It hurts here.
The doctor advises certain laboratory tests to be done. The results are as follows. The doctor gets the lab reports and thinks about the possible diagnosis. He consults with the pathologist and thinks that the elevated liver enzymes, low platelets, increased bilirubin level, decreased RBC, and other abnormalities can be indicative of a rare condition called HELLP syndrome. To be sure, he takes the opinion of a fellow consultant. Before we see their conversation, let us have an overview of HELLP syndrome. It is a group of symptoms which develop usually before the 37th week of pregnancy or within 48 hours of delivery. This rare and idiopathic condition affects less than 1% of pregnant women. This number may seem insignificant, however, owing to its high mortality rate, this condition should not be overlooked.
My patient is presenting the following symptoms: acute pain in right hypochondrium and epigastrium, malaise, nausea, vomiting, headache, blurring of vision, slurring of speech, exacerbation of the symptoms during the night. So in my opinion, this presentation satisfies the triad of HELLP syndrome, that is, hemolysis, elevated liver enzyme and low platelets. Before starting treatment, considering this as a definitive diagnosis, do you agree with my clinical interpretation?
Have you ruled all the differentials?
Yes, idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura, systemic lupus erythematosus and hemolytic uremic syndrome were considered by me. But all the diagnostic parameters indicate total HELLP syndrome.
I concur with your diagnosis. Let's go ahead with the treatment protocol for HELLP syndrome and preeclampsia.
The patient has recovered successfully after treatment. The doctor and patient have a conversation about possible post-treatment complications.
You are very lucky to have survived. This syndrome can be fatal if not diagnosed on time. Up to 25% women do not survive this. Unexpected rapid deaths because of HELLP syndrome require forensic testing. It is great that you did not suffer from a hepatic rupture. It usually results in death. Hemorrhage and stroke may also occur.
You detected it early, so you saved my life. Thank you so much.
Corticosteroid treatment worked wonders for you and your baby. It promoted lung maturity, and for you, your edema diminished, thrombocytic microangiopathic anemia was prevented, which means that your blood vessels don't get blocked. Your platelet count has also improved significantly.
We hope this video simplified the topic in a thought-provoking and engaging manner. Thank you for your patient listening.
Well done, team Hive Minds. Now it is another performance by team Vitals on the topic Graves' disease.
Thyroid hormones assist in BMR regulating activities. For now, to be more precise, let's go with Graves' disease specificities. If you're wondering what could be the etiology, well, it's all about the autoimmunology. It all starts when self becomes non-self and T3, T4 reach blood without TSH help. Synthesis of TSH takes place against TSH receptors at a rapid pace. Here comes the time when thyroid gland says, TSH, I'm sorry, can't say no to the antibody. TSH made it work for only an hour until now, while TSH deceived, making it work for 12 hours right now. Alas, body size.
situation now got out of control. Hence, T3-T4 leaves TSH reduces its diamond dozen analysis. Your eyes pop out, you look like you freaked out. Bulging eyes, vision twice, escaping doctor wouldn't be wise. Your hands start shaking and your muscles start wasting. Heart starts racing and BP starts rising. Eyes start becoming dry and gritty, even lacrimal fluid can't rescue my tea. Skin is moist and heat intolerant, besides itching, sweating and winter is prominent. Radioiodine therapy and medications are nemesis. Breaking the wing of the butterfly also keeps its promises.
Let's continue on the same topic, Graves' disease, by team Eternal Adrenaline.
Thyroid gland is an endocrine butterfly who gave the wings for T3 to fly. Soon that I'm compelled T3 to cry, as it is assisted under TSI. Oh my god, the T3 arrived. Okay, now say your story. Hello everyone. If you query about my promoter, undoubtedly it is TSH, my dear. I'm the T3 who is omnipotent of your body. Until I was betrayed by TSH autoantibody. From that day I was unruly, became perpetual worker eventually. Your body inquired me about the heat, then I escaped using metabolic rate. Your eyes became puffy and gritty. People stared at you as if you were celebrity. Your clothes are always wet due to sweat. Meanwhile, your friends gifted you perfume set. I'm the T3. I am sorry, I became unruly. I'm the T3. I am sorry, I became unruly. You often listen the song Lub Dub, so and the entry card in Yoga Fans Club. You will exhaust nimbly just walking, yeah man, which will raise your rights on motorbike. I'm the T3. I am sorry, I became unruly. Your handshake solicits your anxiety. Your handshake solicits your anxiety. Only doctor saves you, said Almighty. Antithyroid drugs are the medications. Radiation therapy, surgery can also be used, no limitations.
After the excellent performance by both above the team on the topic Graves' disease, now it's time to physiological times by team Phyzzy Quiz.
Hello and welcome to yet yet another episode of Physiology Minute. This is your host, Ms. Avika Kumar. And today we are back again with some exclusive information. Few personal WhatsApp chats, not of Bollywood actors, but this time of physiology students. And one name was common in all of those chats which we found, which were mostly of toppers, and that was Mr. Guy. Now we are trying to connect with them and trying to ask them, who is he? Who is Guy? But till we try to connect them, you guys stay tuned, because we have for you an amazing set of physiology quiz which we will be playing right now live. So stay tuned. Yes, so hello and welcome to the physics quiz. It's fun while you learn. Before we start with the quiz, you'll have to know that you need to guess the name from the images or the given clues. The name may be either of any disease, cell, structure, organ, process, sign, any effect or any element which is related to physiology. Okay, so the first clue is here. This one is a hormone and it goes somewhat like this. A calculator plus 1 ton plus 2 raise in. Calci ton in. So the hormone is calcitonin. That's the right answer. So let's go ahead. What we have on our screens is a syndrome. Lamb plus urge plus the guy is eating. So eat plus on. So lamb urge eaten. So the answer is Lambert eating syndrome. Moving on to the next thing. This one is a principle as you can see, the guy in this picture is Dale Steyn. So the name itself, Dale, suggests as the principle, which is vasomotor reversal of Dale or Dale's principle. Now let's guess this effect. So this is wolf plus tea or chai plus coffee. So wolf, chai, coffee. Wolf Chekhov effect is the correct answer. The next question here is pretty easy and simple. This is a disease. Sickle plus cell, that is sickle cell anemia. Okay, so this one over here is a syndrome and he is none other than our honorable prime minister. So PM plus S is equal to premenstrual syndrome, which is the correct answer. The next one is a cell. So a plate plus synonym of delayed. Now what can be the synonym of delayed? Let us take it as late. So plate plus late, that is equal to plate late. For our next question, we have a sign to guess. And what is this? Jaw plus N plus dish. Yeah, pretty easy. Jaundice. So jaundice is the right answer. The next one over here is a disease which has led to the worldwide pandemic. But before that, let's just try to guess this one. A gaseous neurotransmitter. It is CO or carbon monoxide. So carbon monoxide plus VIN-19, that is the disease itself, COVID-19. For this clue, which is a disease, this picture was specially taken from MS Dhoni's bike collection. So as the name suggests, it is the Kawasaki disease. And it is also reportedly associated with COVID-19 in children. The next one is pretty interesting over here. It's a sign. So you can see the Colosseum, that is the Colosseum at Rome plus burger. Now can you guess this as a sign? Rome plus burger. It is the Romberg sign. Yeah, that's pretty nice. Moving on to the next one. Wow, it's pretty amazing. She is none other than Hema Malini. She's so gorgeous. So Hema plus, well, this one is a process. So Hema plus toe plus paw plus, what you can see over here is an oasis. So Hema plus paw, toe plus oasis, that is hematopoiesis is the correct answer. Excellent. This one is also pretty easy. It's an organ. So pan plus priest, that is pancreas. Now this one is the last one for today. That is an X, which is on top of the hill plus a log. So X on hill plus log, which is the exon hillock. It's a structure, exon hillock. So thank you for watching with us and joining us for the quiz. Stay tuned for more quizzes with us. Yes, Mr. Backbencher, which book? Bambuligam. But it was something like Gaitong de Genong, right? What is this Bambuligam? Hello. So Nation, I'm as curious as you all are that what is this Bambuligam and what is this Gaitong de Genong? Well, we are not aware about that yet. But we'll be right back with our next episode of Physiology Minutes. Till then, you guys stay safe, stay tuned and keep watching Physiology Time. This is your host Avika Kumar signing off.
What a great performance by Team Phyzzy Quiz. Now it's time for Team SN Potential on the topic Gate Control Theory.
We'll be right back.
reads it, but for sake of formalities, I should dictate. No character was injured during the shooting. This clip bears no resemblance to any person living or dead. Any similarities is purely coincidental. Now, let's enjoy the video.
In the pain pathway, dorsal horn acts like a gate. The stimulation of small pain fibers opens the gate and allows pain transmission. While stimulation of large fibers like touch closes the gate and inhibits the pain transmission. Let's see how it works.
May I come in, ma'am?
Yes, come in. Hey, Matthews, have you done your homework today? Now, just bring your hand forward.
The story has begun. The pain will go and run. Depolarizing membrane throughout all the way.
This pain stimulus generates an action potential which travels through unmyelinated C fibers which make the transmission comparatively slower. As action potential reaches the nerve ending, it causes calcium influx which causes exocytosis of neurotransmitter.
Go neurotransmitter, go!
Go! Action potential, go! Excite the second order neuron.
That's how the substance P released from the pain fibers excites the second order neurons and pain is transmitted to cortex via thalamus and subject perceives the pain.
Ouch, ouch!
A signal went to brain. I was in deep pain. Help me find a path to heal me all the way. Give me touch stimulus, give me life. Bring in caffeine to heal me once again.
Now the subject, by rubbing on the injured area, gives a tactile stimulus and generates an action potential. This time, the action potential travels even faster as it travels from larger A-beta fibers. The action potential travels through collateral of touch fibers, releasing neurotransmitter which inhibits secondary pain fibers. That's how encephalon inhibits brain transmission and closes the gate.
Now I am feeling better.
What a potential performance by team SN Potential. Now again I would like to remind the viewers not to forget about your favorite team. Here is the another performance, team stethoscope on the coronavirus.
Life is beautiful and there is so much to smile about. Always had some turning point. of millions of people. Little did we know what we had to go through. Life was easy and life was simple until you came along. You changed everything to a horrible dawn. We are no more happy. Life is not the same anymore. It's difficult, but not impossible. Everyone can play a part to prevent community spread and save lives. A positive future is not far. Dear COVID, you didn't just take away our goodbyes, you took away the certainty in our lives. You were uninvited and would be forever.
Wonderful performance by team stethoscope on coronavirus. Now it's time for team assessments on the topic immunity.
A cute little boy enters a lift and reaches his respective floor, but when he touches the buttons in the lift, something unusual took place there in which the boy did not expect. A stranger entered his body and started troubling the natives. Let's see what actually happened inside the boy's body.
Wow, this seems to be a nice place. Now, I will search for a good place for myself.
In this way, the stranger found a best place, the liver.
Hey. May I know who you are? And the purpose of your presence here?
No matter who am I, but I wish to stay here.
You're not allowed to do that. Please leave.
Why should I? I won't leave this place.
Cuffer gets annoyed with stranger's behavior and starts eating the stranger, who is non-native. Now the foreign body is well digested by the cuffer and is presented as an antigen with the help of MHC2 molecule.
Thank God. My job is done, but now I should search for TH cell with a green ring on its head, otherwise this antigen's friend may affect each and every tissue in body.
The cuffer sets out in search of TH cell with green ring.
Hey Cuffer. Seems to be you're lost. Where are you heading to?
Hi Nidro. I'm in a search of TH cell with green ring.
You seem to be tired roaming since long. Am I right?
Yes Nidro. I've searched almost all the lymphoid tissues, only lymph nodes are left now.
Okay Cuffer. Get your work done soon. See you later.
Cuffer finally reaches the lymph node and enters into it. After entering it finds the TH cell with green ring.
Could you please stop for a while?
What's the matter, Cuffer?
Could you please check the antigen once?
Okay, show me your antigen and the MHC2 molecule.
It verifies the antigen whether it fits into the TCR or not and the presence of MHC2 with CD8 plus marker.
I should take an immediate action on this as soon as possible. Thank you for informing, Cuffer.
My pleasure. Take this interleukins TH. These might be helpful for you in killing the antigen.
By all the above events, TH cell gets activated and releases IL-2 which stimulates the mitotic gene of TH cell's DNA, which gets divided into TC and T memory cells.
I should make my way to the liver immediately. Hepatocytes need me.
Let's proceed, TC.
The war begins.
Let the victory be ours. Attack everybody. Now release the perforin soldiers.
Okay, Commander.
Now, the H2O enters the cell and causes swelling of the altered self cell, ASC. Finally, the affected cell bursts out. In this way the ASCs are killed and the remaining cells are protected from further infections. After the war, the little boy's liver does not have any affected cells to get infected and his warriors inside are ready to fight with more boosted energy if again the same stranger, that is antigen, attacks in future.
The affected cell, or the pathogen, is coated with opsonin proteins, which in turn attack the TC cells. Further TC cells kills the pathogen or affected cell by apoptosis. Activated TC cells also release various chemicals like gamma interferons, lymphotoxins like tumor necrosis factor or digestive enzymes like granzymes to kill the affected cells or pathogen. The activated TC cells bears a CD95 ligand which is detected by its receptors on the lymphocytes or tumor cells. The receptors generate a target cell death signal which leads to cytolysis of the affected cell.
Hope you have been joined for Farman's Absence Assassins on the topic immunity. Now it's time for Team Trending Tract on the topic Pyramidal Tract.
Hey, I'm Ravi.
Hi guys, this is Mahesh.
Hi, I'm Nitin.
Okay, let's start the conversation. Hey Mahesh, why are you a bit worried today?
Yeah bro, the exams are approaching near and I'm still confusing in remembering these tracks.
Do one thing bro, insert the chip, like red chip that contain tracks into the brain like a robo.
Stop kidding bro.
Okay then, watch the YouTube lecture of tracks in the YouTube.
When I open YouTube, my concentration will shift towards the trending videos and music and songs, and I'd forget about these lectures.
Hey bro, which songs are you watching?
Not a bit, just I like to watch devotional songs and some feel-good music.
Okay, you said that you are interested in watching songs.
Yeah, really.
Okay, Nitin said that he learned the same one tracks in a musical way.
Ask really?
Him about that.
Yeah. Is it really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Nitin, no problem, bro. I have remembered it in a musical way.
Please, Nitin, could you teach it? Could you teach me?
Okay, bro. Chill.
Thank you.
First one of the descending tracks, mostly helpful in performing tasks. These fibers originate from motor cortex world of brain. But some fibers also take origin from the somatosensory areas. 1, 2, 3 of brain. Forming corona radiata now, traveling to the internal capsule down, running down, moving to reside in your gray heart. Approaching the level of the brainstem now, it doesn't gonna stop anymore. Running down, forming your pyramid on the middle of upper surface now. These fibers doesn't stop still, this and down. At the end, I'm realizing it helps in the movements of my heart. Over of most fibers to the opposite side, not all of them somewhere left in the same side. This leads to the formation of pyramid recursion. These two sets of fibers still descend on further to terminate in the motor neurons of anterior gray heart. Running down, starting from the motor cortex of brain, moving to reside in your gray heart. It doesn't gonna stop anymore. It will never be incomplete. It helps in the moments of me. It doesn't gonna stop anymore. Running down, moving to reset your gray heart. These fibers doesn't stop still, this and down. At the end I'm realizing it helps in the moments of my heart.
Nice performance by team trending track. Now it's time for team individual performing on the topic atherosclerosis. Splendid performance by team incredible. Now it's time for team MPKV on the topic action of antibody. Thank you. Super performance by the team MPKV. I hope you are enjoying the fest. Now it's time for team ATP and the riddles of different clinical cases.
fantastic performance by Team ATP. Now I am streaming before you our last performance by the team Vision on the topic Cerebellar Disorder. Please vote and support your favorite performance. Thank you for joining us.
What do you mean?
कमेटी नहीं मुझे कमिटमेंट चाहिए कमिटमेंट चाहिए वरना
कौन है
Proceeding to Dr. Dibya, thank you all for joining us.
So that brings us to the end of the streamings of all the participants for today's category. And as you all know, we had initiated this idea of physiology festival when we were actually starting to experience that our students were getting a little too tired of the online teaching, continuous online teaching. So the thought process was, why not let the students have some fun along with teaching? So that was the generation of the concept of physiology festival. And we were absolutely awestruck with the ideas that our students had come up with, the Lady Harding second semester students. So let me take this opportunity to showcase some of the best events, best ideas that our students had come up with. So now I would request you to please also encourage our second semester students by having a look at some of handpicked ones that we have chosen. It was very difficult for us to choose all these, but still we are trying to showcase some 5-6 videos of our second semester students. Please take a look.
Crying system makes the body work right, and doesn't matter whether you are black or you are white. They share all the glands and they all secrete important hormones to keep us on our feet.
Endocrine system consists of 8 glands. We have the hypothalamus, it is our man. And there is supervision, it's the pituitary gland. Secreting
so Madhuka here.
Controlling other glands, parathyroid and thyroid.
As soon as you're done with the result, you can just mail it across to us. Although I've also WhatsApped you Dr. Gurtu's number, but Dr. Gurtu is on his way to the ministry, sir.
Okay.
So we will collate the two results, and then as soon as we're over with the videos here, we will request you to announce the prizes. So we will also WhatsApp you the prize. The
prizes of the first 3 days, sir. Can you please announce those? Thyroid gland secretes pituitary for in calcitonin. Its excess secretion makes a person very thin. Its guide role is to control the rate of metabolism. Over secretion causes hypothyroidism. But bande ko lagti hai bahut zyada garmi, thoda kaam karke kehta hai bas ab aur nahi. Thyroid ke piche we have parathyroid. Iske overactivity se your bones get destroyed. Secretion is parathyrin, which helps absorb calcium from your intestines. On the upper pole of kidney, we have the adrenal. That's why we have called it as suprarenal. Outer cortex secretes neurons like cortic cords. And let me tell you, baby, they're all sterile. In case catecholamines up in a medulla get devoid, to guess it, could you get them stress avoid? Moving on to oxytocin, the hormone for love and protection. It helps in milk ejection and uterine contraction. Newborn babies rely on mammary function. Prolactin is what causes milk production. Adrenal. That's why we have called it as suprarenal. Outer cortex secretes neurons like cortic cords. And let me tell you, baby, they're all sterile. In case catecholamines up in a medulla get devoid, to guess it, could you get them stress avoid? Moving on to oxytocin, the hormone for love and protection. It helps in milk ejection and uterine contraction. Newborn babes rely on mammary function. Prolactin is what causes milk production. Online classes were going on in a flow. I missed my meal and then my blood sugar came low. Glucagon secreted by my alpha cells. Oh, SGD from 2 to 4, remember it well.
endocrine system makes the body work right. It doesn't matter whether you are black or you are white. We share all the glands and they all secrete important hormones to keep us on our feet.
The lockdown started and you stopped using your muscles, I don't have much work to do. You see, I have more spare time with me. Now I'm thinking I look for a friend or a partner to spend my spare time with. What do you call the thing where everyone finds their friends? Oh yes, Tinder. Let me download it and see what good it does to me. Okay, so here I have downloaded it and here I made my profile. How does it look? Quite impressive, isn't it? Okay, now let me have a look who all are available.
Meanwhile,
I am the master of the master gland. I possess various nuclei which can help in catering to your deepest needs. Hormonal balance, ionic balance, temperature, hunger, thirst, you name it and I regulate it. I am the real catch, love.
Hey, stop. Oh my god, hypothalamus, you already do so many things. How will you handle 5 liters of blood? Who's next, please?
A few moments later.
Hello everyone, I'm Stuart Thyroid, the famous gland among all the systems of the body. And if you're looking for an ideal match, come and grab me fast, as I'm in great demand, you know?
Oh, so you're already so famous. Then you don't need me, man. Who's next?
Later.
Good day. My name is Mr. Parathyroid. Keep me healthy and happy. You won't have to worry about your calcium.
Oh goodness, Parathyroid. Who sent this kid on Tinder? What are his parents doing? My son, do something worthwhile. Tinder is not a place for you. Okay, next.
Hi, I'm Adrenal Medulla. I'm always high on adrenaline. I'm forever the life of the party. I would really love for you to take a flight with me to the world of excitatory neural responses. Don't ever let me out of your sight. Together, we can win every fight.
What fight? Do you remember the adrenaline rush that you gave me during my exams? It's a nightmare, Medulla. Next.
I am all-rounder Ovi. I can be your best friend because I'm a very well-coordinated person. So, we will have a good bonding. And together, we can protect a new life.
Yes, yes. Sweet of you, Ovary. Problem is, you're not permanent. What will I do after your menopause? Sorry. Next.
Hello, peeps. I'm the most fun leader you'll ever meet. I love coordinating and receiving feedback from my fellow mates, or shall I say glands. Be it Mr. Thyroid or sweet little adrenal cortex, I love interacting with all of them. I will make you all tall and lean by giving you GH as a gift. And remember that I hold a special corner for little babies. I like them all chubby and healthy. So I help moms nurse them through some prolactin.
Such a long list of functions and hormones. I'm afraid you won't have time for me. Is there no one who can impress me now? Who is next?
The next day.
Hi, lovely. I am student of serious pituitary, a professional environmentalist. Save water, save life. I am a wise man who will fight all the odds to maintain proper balance in your body. I have a sea of love hormones. Along with this, I am a true family man. So, who doesn't like a responsible maturing, huh?
Oh ho, love hormones. Now I can think of you. Let's see what happens. For now, who is next?
Hello, how are you doing? I am possessive pancreas. As you can read in my bio, I am pro at balancing. So baby, take good care of me or I could be the death of you.
But you are already in relationship with sugar. Now I don't want to be friends with you. I'm sorry, pancreas. Who's next?
Hello everyone, I am Professor Thymus. I help in providing immunity to your body by training the T cells so that you can protect yourself and fight against your enemy. So, I'm your ideal match. Also, I'm pretty close to your heart.
I love your fighting spirit, Thymus. But you remember, you shrink with advancing age. I don't want a temporary friend. I'm sorry.
Hi, I am Superb Adrenal Cortex, CEO of Suprarenal Glands. I am here in Tinder, looking for someone special. You might need me because I secrete life-saving hormones.
But I can't forget that you release stress hormones. If I be with you, I'll have to deal with stress more often. I can't handle a cortex. I'm sorry.
Hello, beautiful. I am Testes, the macho man. I live in Scrotum Street, New Cryptorganism City. And if you live nearby and wanna be the apple of my Adam, then hit me up. Kiss baby, I'm a lifelong lover.
I'm afraid I don't want to be Adam's apple. I'm sorry. Let me see some more.
2 hours later.
Cells assemble. So here we are today, having yet another meeting in the middle of this lockdown. I mean, seriously, guys, let me have one day of peace in this lockdown. I'm just chilling at my bones, guys. मेरे अलावा बॉडी में और कोई काम करता भी है कि नहीं?
सर, सर प्लेटलेट नहीं आया. I mean, meeting में प्लेटलेट नहीं आया. He's never on time, sir.
Oh, red, red, blue, green. I'm one of the frontline workers. जब vessels को छोटा आती है, तुमको दिखते भी नहीं हो. I'm the one who saves bone marrow, sir.
Oh, Mr. Platelet. I am the ultimate savior, okay? Queen Victoria की कहानियाँ नहीं सुनी तुमने?
Shut up, guys. Shut up. पहले problem तो सुन लो क्या है?
Yes, RBC. Listen before you speak.
Am I audible? Hello? Hello?
Yes, Pesophil, you are audible, but not visible. Not that anyone wants to see you anyways. Smear mein kabhi dikhe bhi ho aaj tak. Mudde ki baat. Main keh raha tha ki body mein bahut sare symptoms aa rahe hain. Itte sare eruptions ho rahe hain. Does anyone even care? Do you guys?
I do, sir. I do.
Oh, bhai, bolne to de sir ko pehle.
Thank you, Platelet. As I was saying, there have been multiple fevers and allergies and any explanations?
Sir, ye allergies mein na ye lymphocyte ka haath lag raha hai. He's a suspect. Look how he's sanitizing his hands again and again. Dekho ise.
Wait a second. I protect the body and release antibodies too. What else do you want me to do? Aisa bhi nahi hai that eosinophil has noralgin allergies, parasitic infections ke time pe to tum hyperactive ho jate ho. Also, sir ne fever ki baat kari hai. So, neutrophil is an endogen pyrogen.
Wait, what? Main kahan se aa gayi beech mein? Arey yaar, I'm the first line of defense. And please, after tagging all of you in all my pictures, all I get is blame. All of you blame me? Oh my god. Hashtag each betrayal begins with trust. Anyways, mujhe monocyte pe chalte.
Am monocyte. I audible? Hello?
Monocyte, any answers?
Actually, sir, my mic is not working.
Oh, okay, I understand. So, wait a minute. You think I'm an idiot? How are you speaking right now?
Sorry, sir, you caught me. Actually, sir, I just want to say that I just compliment the work of neutrophil and I help in phagocytosis. So, I don't think I should even be suspected here, okay?
Okay. Guys, there have also been cases of hemoglobin urea. What about that? RBC, any explanations?
क्या कुछ प्रॉब्लम हुआ सर?
प्रॉब्लम ये है कि हमारे लोग शहीद हो रहे हैं यूरिन में. बाय द वे सर, आप यूरिन में हीमोग्लोबिन निकल रहा है तो आरबीसी से क्यों पूछ रहे हैं? मैं हूं ना यहाँ पे. एंड इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ व्हाट यू ऑल थिंक, आई एम नॉट अंडर आरबीसी. मेरा खुद का इंपॉर्टेंस है या नहीं? मतलब आई मीन आई कैरी ऑक्सीजन, मैं ब्लड को रेड कलर प्रोवाइड करता हूँ, पर क्या सारा क्रेडिट आरबीसी ले जाता है? मैं क्या करूँ फिर, जॉब छोड़ दूँ?
ओ हेलो, मैं हूं तो तुम हो.
सीरियसली? मतलब जिस दिन मैंने ना स्ट्राइक कर दी, उस दिन तुम रेड ब्लड सेल से सिर्फ ब्लड सेल बन जाओगे. फिर ढूंढते रहना अपने इलेक्ट्रॉन.
हेलो, अरे यार, किसी पर हंसने से बेहतर है कि हम किसी के साथ हंसे, क्योंकि यही छोटी छोटी खुशियां तो जिंदगी का सहारा बनती हैं.
क्या?
अरे, आई मेंट डोंट लाफ ऑन अदर्स, लाफ विद अदर्स. दीज स्मॉल थिंग्स डोंट मैटर.
Small things don't matter. Plasma G, हाइपोवोलेमिया हो रहा है बॉडी में. आप तो ना किसी के साथ हंसी और ना किसी के ऊपर, प्लीज.
सर, आई एम 55% शेयर होल्डर इस कंपनी. यू कैन नॉट टॉक टू मी लाइक दैट. मैं सीनियर बंदा हूँ. आई कैरी ऑल द न्यूट्रिएंट्स एंड आयंस. यू कैन टॉक टू द प्लाज्मा प्रोटीन्स अंडर मी टू.
आयंस की तो बात ही मत करो. Have I told you guys about the hyperkalemia and the hypocalcemia going on? क्या हो रहा है यार?
सर सर, am I audible? सर मेरे को बस एक बात क्लियर करनी थी. सर मैं मीटिंग में कुछ बोलने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ, ना मुझे कुछ सुनाई दे रहा है ना मुझे कुछ दिखाई दे रहा. सर वैसे ही मैं इतना काम करता हूँ कि पैरिन मैं सिक्रेट करता हूँ, हिस्टामिन मैं सिक्रेट करता हूँ, सारा क्रेडिट मैं सेल को ले देते हैं आप लोग. मुझे कोई पूछता क्यों नहीं है? बेसोफिल हूँ मैं बेसोफिल हूँ. बेशक से मैं स्मेयर में नहीं दिखता हूँ, पर मैं काम करता हूँ. मैंने बहुत स्ट्रगल किया है सर.
हाँ बेसोफिल, हाँ. Just chill, please. Plasma proteins.
Our regular work is going in our department. Albumin is maintaining the oncotic pressure. Globulin is assisting the lymphocytes in the antibody reaction. And the fibrinogen is helping out platelets. Am I right, platelet?
Please, don't talk to me. I don't want to talk to you or anyone else in this matter. मेरे को ये जॉब ही नहीं पसंद है. I hate you all. मम्मी यार टीवी का वॉल्यूम कम करो.
हेलो
एल, म्यूट है भाई तू, म्यूट है.
एज आई वॉज सेइंग, बोथ हीमोस्टेसिस एंड कोगुलेशन इज वर्किंग फाइन, सो नो नीड टू टॉक टू मी.
सर मे आई से समथिंग?
हाँ भाई, रेटिकुलस लाइट, तुम भी बोल लो अब.
सर एवर सिंस आई हैव स्टार्टेड वर्किंग आई हैव ऑलवेज लुक्ड टू आरबीसी सर. मुझे उन्हीं की तरह बड़े होकर बनना है, बड़ी बड़ी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज लेनी है.
ओ भाई पॉइंट पे आ जा, सबके पास काम है, कोई वेला नहीं बैठा है यहाँ.
क्यों, हमारा देखना है.
एज आई वॉज सेइंग सर, आरबीसी सर मेरे लिए परफेक्ट है, मेरे रोल मॉडल है. आई इवन कांट थिंक ऑफ blaming him, but वो कुछ बदले बदले से लग रहे हैं.
Oh, so you got me. Actually, I'm not from your body. I came from transfused blood transfusion.
Oh my god. That explains the fever. That explains the jaundice and the hypocalcemia and the hyperkalemia and the. It explains everything. You are such an evil person. I mean, because of you, we had to have this meeting, yaar. In idiots ko aapas mein ladte aur jhagadte dekhkar mera dimag kharab ho gaya. I mean, seriously. I could have slept, man. Come on.
If you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together.
He means if we go hand in hand, no one can harm us. It's a teamwork.
You're right, guys. So, sales, disassemble.
Bye. So, sir, I have, you know, stained myself. I might have overstained, but now I think I'm visible and audible as well. So, I was talking about this minority rights and blood. Hello? 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 मुझे कोई पूछता ही नहीं है यहाँ पे.
let them know. Well, now they know. Let us go. Let us go. Let's go find out what it is. Let us go. Let us go. Even though I know it's nothing good. Cause I have double vision and have a high heart rate. Let the doctors ignore. Cause Google says I have cancer. I'm out of breath and I feel like giving up any time. Oxygen saturation of hemoglobin is low. It's time to see what I can do to test the limits and victor. No, I cannot, no sports for me. I'm scared. Let us go, let us go. Let's go find out what it is. Let us go, let us go. Even though we know it's nothing good. Here I stand, and here I survive. Let's get to therapy. Cause doctors know what they have to do.
Top down, right, left, the blood flow inside the chest. Atrium ventricles are the best, pumping blood even at the SNO sparks the heart. 1500 beats to start. Found atrium on the right, deep pulverizing down the heart.
AV note, atrial ventricular 40 to 60 beats in particular. Bundle of his next in conduction. Apex to heart's ventricle contraction. Purkinje fibers next in conduction. It's all about heart electrical function.
Listen to your heart. When he's calling for you, listen to your heart. There's nothing else you can do.
Welcome to the ECG Nation. Let me bring you the translation. P for the atrial QRS or ventricle depolarization, but the ventricle depolarizes with the D situation. To check the heart rate, you will have to wait 1500 upon the squares on ECG plate. For rhythm, we start to debate. Regular or irregular, we just relate.
Here comes deviation from the cardiac axis determination. Just P1 and V2 relation. Whether approach or move away judging is all by imagination. When the PRA log is, just look at the clock. 1, 2, 3, tell which kind of heart block. Flutter or fibrillation, it is us to unlock. ST elevation may knock you off.
Listen to your heart. When he's calling for you, listen to your heart. There's nothing else you can do.
Sounds more than don't ignore. Someone makes the noise love. Then the ventricles say, hey blood, welcome to the club. It's a sound which is low pitch and loud and makes the AV walls happy and proud. Sound poo makes a noise that. Then the ventricles say, hey blood, have fun in the aortic duct. It's a sound which is high pitch and sharp and makes the SL look like a heart. If your heart's got a bad luck, and believe me, it really sucks. It makes your heart sound like a cat's purr and its name is a murmur.
Listen to your heart. When he's calling for you, listen to your heart.
Hey buddy, what's up? You seem dull today?
Nothing, man. Medical school is killing me, especially physiology.
Physiology can be tricky, but it's very interesting once you get the hang of it. What unit troubles you the most?
CNS is so difficult for me to understand.
Say no more. Let me teach you basal ganglia connections in a super fun way.
मेरा ओ मेरा ओ
And no talking, please, Hannah. So now we have come to the end of our festival. While we are awaiting the result of the day, let us take an opportunity to share our experience and express our gratitude to all. As all of you have watched over these 4 days, we had a participation from all corners of India. Be it Imphal from East India, Kathua from North India, Jodhpur from West India, or Chennai from South India. As our respected director sir has said on the inaugural day, this festival brings undergraduate students together on a single platform. To have more than 3,000 students across the country coming together to view and participate is the single most defining moment of this festival. A truly overwhelming feeling for all of us in the organizing team.
Yes, indeed. One of the first emails that we had received inquiring about the festival was by a student who signed himself or herself as physiophobic. Yes, physiophobic, a heart-wrenching thing indeed to read for any physiologist. I hope that our small endeavor to provide a platform for the students to express physiology creatively helped to make physiology a little more exciting, stimulating, inspiring, and enjoyable, and hopefully estranging the word phobia from physiology. The question isn't who is going to let me, it's who is going to stop me. These are the famous lines by author Ayn Rand. We sincerely hope that this festival has been able to bring about this confidence in our undergraduate students.
Surely, and it would not be proper if we fail to give the due to the second semester students of our institute. As our respected head of the department, Dr. Mondal, had shared on the inaugural day that when we first conducted the physiology festival at an institutional level, and when we announced this intra-semester festival to our second semester students, they were that time battling lockdown blues and online teaching pressure. Though a little skeptical to begin with, our second semester students not only rose up to the challenge, but also created such wonderful marvels that it left us completely awestruck by their innovative approach. We had a glimpse of some of the ideas earlier. It is primarily their enthusiasm that impelled us to believe in the potential of our students and to dream about expanding the festival at an all India level. Thank you and kudos to all second semester students.
Way to go, girls. We would like to express have we muted the others? We would like to express our gratitude towards our team of residents who have worked non-stop towards making this dream of an All India Physiology Festival a reality. When we planned and decided to conduct this festival, there was possibility of colleges being opened in another fortnight, leaving us with serious time limitation. However, our residents took upon themselves and worked tirelessly towards finishing each task well ahead of time. Thank you, Dr. Ayan, Dr. Priyanka, Dr. Mayank, and Dr. Sonu for coordinating your individual categories so well. All of you were constantly in touch with all the participating students, helping them, addressing their concerns, resolving their issues, keeping them motivated with infinite patience. At times, we've also seen WhatsApp popping up at 12 midnight and our residents replying to them absolutely politely. Our team of residents took personal initiative at every step, despite all the personal challenges like being COVID positive, appearing for interviews in a different city, and some had some other health issues to tackle. Our postgraduate students, Dr. Divya and Dr. Manveer, have also been constantly involved with all the background work. We are truly fortunate to have such dedicated residents in our department. Three cheers for our team of residents. I am truly grateful to my colleague, Dr. Anita Pawar, Joint Organizing Secretary of the festival. I'm fortunate to have such a wonderful team member, wherein we as a team are able to complement each other, thus making a complete team.
Thank you, Dr. Madhulika. I 100% agree with you. It wouldn't have been possible without our mutual understanding and coordination. Now, we would also like to thank our head of the department, Dr. Mondal ma'am. She's a motivation for all of us in the department. She's a true leader who leads by example, by working the hardest among all, always supporting and motivating us to do more. Thank you, ma'am.
Lastly,
and most importantly, we thank our physiology fraternity. The idea of the festival was too well received and appreciated by our seniors and colleagues, which was beyond our expectations. We recognize that it is primarily your encouragement and belief in your students that motivated the students to participate in such a large numbers. We sincerely cherish the faith that you showed in our idea. Thank you so much.
Thank you from our side. And now I guess let's get over with the suspense of the prizes. So I request first of all our esteemed judge, Dr. K.K. Deepak. So please, first of all, your comments about today's performance, sir. So please unmute yourself. And okay, sir, I also request you to please log off from the YouTube link, sir. Or sir, just mute it if.
Yeah, it's muted.
Okay. Fine, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Sure. So good afternoon, everybody, my physiology colleagues all over India. I'm very happy to be here. I'm very thankful and very happy with the kind of organization which has been going on for the last 4 days. And thanks to Lady Harding Medical College and these beautiful ladies who have organized this wonderful task, Madhulika and Anita. Hats off to you and Dr. Sunita Mondal. I'm so proud of you that you have given us this new directionality to this. When I received this message, I was wondering what is this? But when I went into it, it is an innovation. This is the first time I've seen such kind of innovation happening. And there have been a quiet learning to physiologists about a non-physiology things, which I always called kind of a hidden curriculum. Like when I was seeing today's videos and other things, I was seeing so much hidden talent is there among people. It's not that the one who comes to a physiologist is just a physiologist. It's a human being. And all human beings have a potential to be uncovered. And this festival, in true sense, has given opportunity and chance for people to uncover themselves the potential. And the potential put together with the physiology always gives a leap and bounds progress. So therefore, I again congratulate to the team physiology at Lady Harding Medical College, who did a wonderful work and wonderful showcasing here. I'm also very helpful and thankful for young guys, your senior residents and junior residents who must have worked hard, head in hand, and shoulder to give this performance. I understand without any this kind of a differences and differences being sorted out, this is the only thing which happens when you come as a team. That's why the team performance is always bigger than individual performance. And that's what we see today. It is performance of a big team, a big people. And when I see the people participated, they participated throughout the country. And I did learn on a physiology connections and other things that this thing, important thing is going on. So again, wonderful thing, wonderful initiative. And this is a good thing, which because of COVID thing has happened. Normally we see COVID is bad, COVID is bad, but any thing which is causing harm to the community also gives you some opportunities to be open. So this is a new online learning, teaching and interaction opportunities. We have learned a lot. I have learned a lot doing this, doing online things and other things. We know the problem with online, and this is what has been pointed out pointedly at several places. And Lady Harding has given a new way of kind of enrichment of our social lives. And also they have shown how you can enrich physiology. This is a new twist that by using these skills, you are actually causing enhancement in physiology learning. So again, thank you so much. Wonderful to be here. Right. So now I can go to the next thing.
Thank you, sir. So we have Dr. Gurtu with us. So we'll love to hear his comments also, sir, before we announce the prizes.
Certainly.
Yes, sir. Dr. Gurtu, if you can please switch on your camera also and please share your... Yes, sir.
My apologies. I've just come out from a meeting. And my battery is really low. To save on both the battery and the bandwidth, I'm keeping my video off.
Fine, sir. This is
about
one
to
of
go
the
anytime.
That Dr. Deepak said we have of online things.
Yeah, and I would request Dr. Deepak. I heard his thing. I just came out. I've come out on the corridors. I'm in this thing concerning this vaccine thing, you know, so it's I couldn't really share much. But I did see, go through the entire spectrum of the presentations on the... So, on the whole, it was a wonderful kaleidoscope of shifting content with equal relevance, creativity, play, drama, and a lot of expression all around. There was a mix. Some were high on content and relevance as to the physiology issues go, and the others were high on creativity and yet others on action. But what sustained me throughout of, and 2.5 hours is a very long time on online platforms. And yet I could sustain my attention and interest periodically going in and out during a meeting was the fact that regardless of other variations in expressions and everything else, content, what was common to all of them was they were all high on fun. It was fun. Each and every one I have marked very high on fun content, the fun aspect. They were expressions of heart, and that is what art is really. So I don't know what others learned, but going through this entire canvas of creativity, I learned that there are two approaches to learn physiology, and which I am learning still as a clinician. Physiology interests me a lot, especially the high altitude aspects. What I'm learning is there are two approaches that students have shown. One is the approach that I thought was the right and the only approach. You gather facts, you collect and collate facts, you analyze them, you synthesize them, and you form memories, chunk them up for future use, replay them when required. That's one, valid, and probably the one that I learned physiology through which medium. The other that this festival of yours shows another pathway to learning, and that is emotion. You learn physiology while doing something else, painting, writing a poem, making an animation, running or planning a skit. And that is how I think the real learning could occur through emotion, through the medium of emotion, using art and literature and such media of expression. And that is how some of the greatest discoveries in physiology and medicine have happened. Kekule's name comes to mind, who, while thinking hard, using the analytic approach, couldn't ran into a stumbling block, couldn't break past it, dozed off in boredom. And as soon as he dozed off, half awake, half asleep, he had a dream or an image. It was an artistic image of a snake devouring its own tail, going round and round and round. And that's how those 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbon atoms coalesced into a circle, and circle became a hexagon. Each carbon got attached to one hydrogen, and that became C6H6, benzene. And that simple half dreaming, half awake creativity moment opened the doors to a whole new world, organic chemistry. And that world is the world we inhabit right now, the things that surround us, plastics, rubber. That's how a dream, an emotion is tied to the world of creation. And probably that is what your festival has taught me, using art as a learning tool, learning medicine or physiology while doing something else in a fun way. So that's what I thought, or a blend of the two. And on the whole, it was fun throughout, and I could remain awake, not just awake, engaged, not just engaged, emotionally there, present, despite so many distractions of the meeting in and out as I went through. So thank you for that. And I hope that this develops into a more broader platform. I mean, getting in more networks onto this kind of a creative collaborating. I mean, learning through the medium, learning physiology through art that way. Yeah, thanks.
We surely try and incorporate that, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Dr. Sunita, ma'am, please, if you can please share your ideas, comments.
Yeah, Dr. Madhulika, I think I'll be very brief. But just like the last 3 days, today's session, just not remove myself.
Ma'am, your audio is a little unclear. Can you come near the microphone, please?
Okay. What I was saying is, today's experience was really exuberant and spellbounded, like the other 2 days, the other 3 days. It was too good, and I could not just help but sitting through continuously. I have seen all the 14 presentations, and I want to thank all of you, my whole team, the participants, the faculty who have taken interest, and all judges, our esteemed judges. This tour has actually been a blend of art of science. We are humbled by the overwhelming responses from the students all over India. Thank you. So thank you. I think now, Dr. the students would be waiting for it. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you. So, may I?
Yes, sir, please, sir.
So, now the time has come for the most important event. And before that, I would like to say one word. I must congratulate all those who participated in it, because the participation is very, very important. And many times, it's very difficult for judges to judge. And I myself faced a lot of, there were so many good entries and so many good people who were participating in this. I also congratulate for people, for the organizer part, who have performed well in order to bring this to fore. So coming towards the result aspect, I announced day-wise results, and there have been 4 events, the skit, poetry, animation, and miscellaneous, for lasting for 4 days. And each category, there are 4 awards. So at day one, like 4 awards: audience choice award, judges award, third, second, and first. So I'll go in that sequence. So first, to announce the results of the skit, do pay attention. This is a very important thing coming out now. The audience choice award for the day one skit goes to Metabolic Masters, MEMC, Delhi. Metabolic Masters, Maulana Azad Medical College, Delhi. that is the Audience Choice Award. In this category, Judges Award, third in series, has gone to two, the tie, and the two are Covians Government Medical College, Pali, congratulations. Number two, Kathua Combatants, Government Medical College, Kathua. So these two, they deserve applause. So we can clap for them, although it's very difficult to hear clap on this platform. The judges award second in the series for the skit, that is the day one, goes to Transmissible Musketeers, Lady Harding Medical College. Congratulations. For the skit, the first award, judges' first award goes to Metabolic Masters, Maulana Azad Medical College. Congratulations. You also won Audience Award and First Award. You really must have run very well. So over to the day two, poetry. The Audience Award goes to ASK Chaturveda Ritwik, Government Medical College, Nalgonda, Telangana. Congratulations. In the field of poetry, judges' third award, again there is a tie, and it goes to Shristi Kishore and members, JSS Medical College, Mysuru. Second one, Roshni Rajoria, Institute of Postgraduate Medical Education and Research, SSKM Hospital, Kolkata. Congratulations to both. We can clap for them. Judges' second award for the poetry day two competition. Again, there is a tie, and it goes to two teams, Jagrat Neel Kaur, Lady Harding Medical College. Congratulations. PRK Tanmay and members, Usmania Medical College, Hyderabad. Congratulations. So, congratulations to Lady Harding and Usmania. Judges' first award in the field of poetry goes to Raghunandini Singh, GMC Kathua. Congratulations. GMC Kathua. So nice, these medical colleges are doing so well. Awards for the day three, animation. Audience Choice Award goes to Team Symporters, Rangarai Medical College, Kakinada, Andhra Pradesh. Congratulations. Judges' third award in the field of animation goes to, again, Team Symporters, Rangarai Medical College, Kakinada, Andhra Pradesh. Congratulations. So they win two awards. Judges' second award in the field of animation, there's a tie. It goes to two teams. First is Team 4AB Vitals, Namo Medical Education and Research Institute, Silvassa. Congratulations. Number second, Team Reminiscence, Rural Medical College, Prabhara Institute of Medical Sciences, Loni, Maharashtra. Congratulations. The first award by judges in the field of animation goes to Team Medic Rodgians, Atal Bihari Bajpayee Institute of Medical Sciences, and Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia Hospital, New Delhi. Congratulations. Coming to day four, which is miscellaneous, where I've been one of the judges here, the Audience Choice Award goes to Team Vision, GMC Telangana. Congratulations. Judges' third award goes to Team SN Potential, SN Medical College, Jodhpur. And also, there's a tie, Team Vitals, Government Medical College, Suryapet. Congratulations for both the team. The second award, judges, second award for miscellaneous group. Again, there's a tie, goes to two teams, Hive Minds, Surat Medical, Surat Municipal Institute of Medical Education and Research, Surat, and also Team Phyzzy Quiz, GMERS, Medical College, Vidyanagar, Vadnagar. Congratulations. The first award for judges for miscellaneous goes to Bernard Elias, Jhalawar Medical College, Rajasthan. Congratulations. So finally, I congratulate all the teams, all the support people who supported these teams, their colleges, their principal, and their administration who have made them available for this work. So again, congratulations to the background teams and people. So I'm so happy to be here to announce these results. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. My hearty wishes to all the winners. As Dr. Deepak sir have already said, participation is the most important thing. So for the runners, don't worry. There is still a lot more to go. You all definitely will get another platform to prove yourself. My best wishes too. You all have made this festival a more memorable and enjoyable one. Thank you all. Now I request Dr. Manvi Singh Mathur, postgraduate student in the Department of Physiology, Lady Hortons Medical College, to give out of thanks. Sir, please.
Thank you, Dr. Divya. Thank you all for being with us. I hope you all have enjoyed All India Online Physiology Festival 2020. As we come to the end of this festival, I, Dr. Manvi Singh Mathur, PG third year, deem it a great honor and privilege to propose the word of thanks. Once again, I would like to thank our organizing committee, Dr. N.N. Mathur, Dr. Sunita Mondal, Dr. Madhulika Monga, Dr. Anita Pawar, Dr. Ayan Goswami, Dr. Priyanka Sharma, Dr. Sonu Kumar Bhardwaj, Dr. Mayank Agarwal, Dr. Divya Ranjan Rajendran, for making this event a great success. I also thank our respected judges, Dr. Tanmay Talukdar, Dr. Mona Bedi, Dr. Basab Gupta, Dr. Himani Aluwalia, Dr. A.K. Jain, Dr. Manju Sabarwal, and Dr. K.K. Deepak, and Dr. Anil Gurtu, for being with us. Last but not the least, I thank our audience and participants who have made this wonderful 4 day of skit, poetry, animation, and miscellaneous presentations a memorable one. Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much. Thank you for being with us. Thanks. Bye. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Bye-bye.